WWL forecast, mostly cloudy, milder today. 20% rain chance, high of 72. More clouds tonight and a 40% possibility of showers, low of 49. Tomorrow, 30% rain chance for rain. Then turning partly to mostly cloudy, it'll be cooler and breezy. High of 58, 40% rain chance on Saturday, 60% on Sunday. Airport Union Center, cloudy 66 and 58 in Slidell. I'm Jim Hansen, WWL First News. Take a look at WWL traffic.
From the WWL Traffic Center, right, Bob Frost, and traffic still in good shape as you make your way across the Body Carey Spillway between the Fox and Chenier. And looking good on the I-10 through Chenier and Battery. I got some slow traffic as you leave New Orleans East on 610. Headed to Battery, this is going to be right around Canal Boulevard. Opens up after the 10-610 split in Battery. And as you make your way into New Orleans East, approaching the Pontchartrain Expressway. Stopping good traffic back around now. Cleveland through the Claiborne flyover. Opens up after Loyola. Looks good crossing the Crescent City Connection. Same for the Huey Long Bridge. And some slow and go as you leave the New Orleans East area. This is going to be right around the 10-610 split. And that opens up a little bit right after that. We do have accidents. Bryant at 3rd. Payne Boulevard at Bullard. Franklin at North Claiborne. Chestnut at Tennyson. Collins at Joliet, Reed at Springwood, and Airline Highway at Livingston. And your traffic brought to you by David Bryant.
That feeling when the dress of your dreams is on sale? Select wedding dresses, originally $300 to $600, are now just $99. Plus $20 off bridesmaid dresses. Be your own bride, only at David Bridal. Sale in February 21st.
Have a traffic tip, call WWL 504-260 info.
Noel Norman, opinion leader on WWL-AM-FM.com. Call 504-260-1870 or text 870-870. Welcome back. We've been talking about the state of the article that was done by Politico Magazine in the aftermath of the State of the Union address. And it's something I think that they do every year or something along those lines. And it ended up ranking Louisiana as being 51st in this country, which is
development organization for the city of New Orleans. So we work very closely with Chenier Inc. at the regional level as well as Louisiana Economic Development. The goal for us is to make New Orleans the most capital attractive city for human capital and financial investment.
Awesome. So I know that y'all had an opportunity to review this report. What are y'all's thoughts?
So really there's three big picture thoughts. The first thought is, if you look at it on census data alone, we know that historically we have too many of our fellow neighbors and friends who are living in poverty, too many who are not necessarily achieving what they should through education. But what that extensive census information doesn't do is, the second one, it doesn't talk about trajectory or momentum, the upward progress. And as we're about to prove to you, well, let me just give an analogy for a lot of sports fans, and I know you're a sports fan. If you looked at simple measurables, Tom Brady would have been forecasted to be out of the league 16 years ago. He's arguably going to go down with Drew Brees as one of the greatest quarterbacks of this era, because what static numbers can't measure are resiliency, they can't measure grit, they can't measure things that make Louisiana and New Orleans distinctive and attractive for people. And the final thing I think what the political article misses is, yes, there's work to be done, but that work isn't isolated to Louisiana. And it doesn't factor what's happening in the metro area, which is really a good thing. We are becoming one of those places where young people will move to the job. So that fundamentally allows you to be an attractive mecca for talent.
You know, Tyler, what has struck me is that the article is published. And it seems as though there's been a collaborative effort among state and local players to say, wait a second, we're not going to just sit back and take this lightly. We're going to address this, and we're going to put our best foot forward, and we're going to try to explain to everyone what is actually going on. And I love the analogy that you just used.
that, you know, static and being dynamic, and resiliency and grit are two intangibles that are not measured on any study. And I, in the previous half hour, we had Ava Deshwa on it, and she talked about the happenstance after Katrina, where people were questioning whether or not we wanted to come back. Well, then we came back.
Right.
You know, in many areas, we're stronger than we've ever been before.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And what those bits of data and a lot of those data that we appreciate is the fact that Louisiana, and particularly people in this region, have a strong sense of place. We have tremendous philanthropic contributions to our local communities. We have tremendous presence along the country. Hundreds of highly desirable professors. We have great law enforcement teams. So there are a lot of things that we don't talk about the other people. As I would say, and I think the fact that they're about, if you look at the fact that they're we are in the middle of it, yes. We've got a lot of work to do. There's a lot of things that we need to overcome. But if you want to, again, use a sports analogy, if you want to see the right of the playoffs or the Super Bowl championship among states, Louisiana will be a very solid day.
Yeah, and I mean, yeah, it struck me as odd when I was reading the article of all of the recent releases about New Orleans and the greater metropolitan region, as well as the state of Louisiana, finishing so high in so many different independent studies and surveys and quality of life indicators, so many of those things, and then all of a sudden, boom, you read this.
Yeah, no, it's a great point you make. The one thing that is lost when you look at articles like this is what are they measuring? What are the metrics? And if you're not measuring a bunch of static variables that are based upon the past, or, you know, they're 2 to 3 to 4 years old, it doesn't talk about the momentum that you have here. For example, in case one of education,
let's hold that because we've got to get to a break, and we'll pick up on that point, the K-12 education, and we'll talk more about this. If you want to weigh in on this subject, give us a call, 260-1870, or text us at 870-870. This is Joel Norman and Quentin Messer on WWL.
Living in their own life.
You can contact Long Branch Wellness Center at 504-6-